given us a new opportunity to reach our communities. We've expanded our food bank, we've started a hot meal initiative serving the most vulnerable in our city, as well as the NHS and key workers. We have an online counselling service and a hopeline, so there's always somebody to talk to. Since the beginning of lockdown, we've given out over 10,000 hot meals and 10,000 food bags. And we thank God because it's only just the beginning. We're preparing to expand what we're doing to continue to meet the needs of our community.
We need to stop looking for our purpose in everything else and find our purpose in loving the Lord our God.
I'm not focused on the division and the racial strife, though it's real and genuine. We have to take a stand for justice. I'm focused on the joy of heaven.
Be courageous enough, compassionate enough, and righteous enough to stand out, speak out, and act out in this nation, because this nation needs Jesus.
Speak to the mountain. Do you know what? That mountain, that demonic force, that principality and power, it's gone. We have to shift in the name of Jesus.
Very active singing is causing you to actually put two and two together and see where the enemy's been lying to you and where the Lord has been telling the truth to you.
Lockdown has given us a new opportunity to reach our communities. We've expanded our food bank, we've started a hot meal initiative serving the most vulnerable in our city, as well as the NHS and key workers. We have an online counselling service and a hopeline, so there's always somebody to talk to. Since the beginning of lockdown, we've given out over 10,000 hot meals and 10,000 food bags. And we thank God because it's only just the beginning. We're preparing to expand what we're doing to continue to meet the needs of our community.
Our purpose in everything else and find our purpose in loving the Lord our God.
I'm not focused on the division and the racial strife, though it's real and genuine. We have to take a stand for justice. I'm focused on the joy of heaven.
Be courageous enough, compassionate enough, and righteous enough to stand out, speak out, and act out in this nation, because this nation needs Jesus.
Speak to the mountain. And do you know what? That mountain, that demonic force, that principality and power, it's gone. You have to shift in the name of Jesus.
Very act of singing is causing you to actually put two and two together and see where the enemy's been lying to you and where the Lord has been telling the truth to you.
Lockdown has given us a new opportunity to reach our communities. We've expanded our food bank. We've started a hot meal initiative serving the most vulnerable in our city, as well as the NHS and key workers. We have an online counselling service and a hopeline, so there's always somebody to talk to. Since the beginning of lockdown, we've given out over 10,000 hot meals and 10,000 food bags. And we thank God because it's only just the beginning. We're preparing to expand what we're doing to continue to meet the needs of our community.
Hi, welcome to Destiny Church Online. Wherever you are connecting from, this is the right place where you'll find peace, love of God, and inspiration. There are pastors who are ready to connect with you. Right now, we're coming into a very important moment, a word that will change your life. We're hearing this word from our own senior pastor, Sue Owen. Faith, not fear. God bless you.
Hey, it's so good to be with you today, Destiny family. Sue Owen here with you. If you're visiting, I just want to give you a warm welcome. I also want to say thank you to all of those of you who've remained loyal and devoted, active and involved. God bless you and thank you for all of the different things that have been happening. Recently, we've been through so many changes, and it's a privilege for me to come and share with you today. And my topic is faith, not fear. I'm mindful, folks, that the world has changed dramatically. Maybe since we spoke like this in days gone by, the world has changed absolutely beyond recognition. And you may be struggling with fear right now. And I'm praying today that this word will help you and bring some truth to you. I am surrounded by information. I want to tell you right now what's been going on through the Destiny Network. Do you know, since lockdown occurred, we've had 163 unique hours of broadcasting for you all to look at. It's been regarding the kids' work, church online services, and the Romanian content, but it's not including Surge, which is a whole bundle of information and teaching in its own right. It's not including Destiny College, the things that you've learned both in the room, but then you've now got the opportunity to go back over and listen in again about teachings and discipleship and all the different ministries that have been coming in to share through college. This 163 hours doesn't include the online growth groups. And would you believe it? We have got, I can't find my numbers right now, but we've over 130, I think it is, growth groups happening every week by Zoom. Would you believe that? And you can plug into some of those if you like. We also have been broadcasting The Box on the Diamonds Facebook page fortnightly, just recently on a Friday night at 7. That's for the women to be discipled in faith and fellowship, praying together and learning about God. We really want to assault the fear. And right now, hopefully, these statistics are giving you some info so that you know what you could maybe look into to find some answers for your life. Maybe you want to find friendship through some of these groups that I've mentioned. I'll talk about The Box right at the end again today before I finish sharing. But I want to encourage you that we've, as leaders, the pastors have been exceptional. We've probably over 30 pastors involved today, just ready to pray with you. And you'll have the opportunity at the end of this message. But you know what? Faith over fear. Before I go further, I want to mention about the food as well, mind. We've had over 14,200 meals going out. 14,200 hot meals going out. We've also had over 14,000 food bags going out with multiple meals in there. That's been engaging 44 active volunteers. Did you know that? And if you still want to volunteer, please do get in touch with us. Let one of the pastors know at the end of this session. We've been working alongside 8 agencies in and around our cities to really meet need. So maybe that's where your fear is based. It's to do with your resources, your food, and the things that you're going to need from day to day and week to week as the months go by now. Don't be alone. Don't be cut off. Get in touch. So I really wanted to start today by giving you some stats about what's been happening through church. But, you know, the word says without faith, and you may have heard me share before, I've done different talks in times gone by through TBN and with the Box Ladies and now through sharing at a church. I've done different talks on faith, but I learned something new the other day. Hebrews 11:6, without faith, it's impossible to please God. That word without actually describes the fact that in your world, you've left a gaping chasm. You've an impassable gulf. That's what without means right here. And we can't pick and choose, folks, as to whether we want to acknowledge faith, nurture it, grow it, or test it. We have to work with faith. We've got to get the word in. None of us wants an impassable gulf when it comes to health issues. None of us wants to have a gaping chasm when it comes to the finance and the picture that we're looking at this month. Tune into this, listen in carefully. Maybe get your notebook and take notes as to what's really relevant for you, because I'm praying it will help you. Colossians 3:16 says, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. That word dwell means to occupy in your house. It means to cohabit with you and remain. It means to have the rule in your home and to take up some space. Do you only look at the word when you actually have to? Or do you only look at the word maybe when you've got someone else helping you with it? I want to encourage you. I said to the Box girls recently, if you're a word nerd, you need to go to the Amplified Classic. If you love conversation, you need to get into the Message. If you're a real student, like Andrew would definitely be speaking of in and around his world, you need the New American Standard Bible. And if you tend to be quite an emotional person, go towards the Passion Translation, because if your vocabulary these days is the Bible's running out of help or it's running dry, something's wrong. I want to say to you folks, when you read your Bible, you're having a conversation with God. He's talking to you. He's talking right into your heart. He's talking into your situation. He's talking into your circumstances, the current picture that you're looking at. Many of you have been homeschooling recently. Many of you have been cut off from the usual help that you would have, maybe through the organisations not being able to get to you, who would normally supply your needs or help you and meet your needs. I want to say to you, you know, you need faith. You also need relationship. I want to enlarge on some of these things as I go through the talk today and say, faith is great, but you need fellowship. You need fellowship because it'll boost your faith. It'll encourage your conversation if you've got the right kind of fellowship. It'll encourage you in your mood today. You'll also be able to watch out for someone else and see how they are. Are they doing okay? Are they well? We've not been able to meet up in homes, as you know. And we've not even been able to meet up in church for months now. But just as this lockdown lifts and we're all venturing back into the world, if you've been one of those that's not had to be a frontline worker, I take my hats off to the retail, to the health services, the security forces, the police, and church pastors. You know, we've just been going full pelt, really. And I'm so grateful that God has surrounded us with a whole team. I cannot tell you how grateful I am for you all. One of the groups was just telling me now, one of the leaders in the groups, she was saying, we've done 5 Zoom meetings with our youth every week since lockdown. That's commitment, folks. We're not here to present for you. We're not here to perform in front of you. We're here to relate with you. And your faith needs to be that essential aspect of your life. It's not an option. It's an essential thing. You must have faith in your life because it'll set your pathway on a good trajectory. But then you also need fellowship. Recently, we've been looking at the information coming from the government, and they've said you need to do it in stages, open up, meet again, and so many different laws, really, about security and all the different disinfectants and all of these things and the different spacings. So we've just coined a phrase, let's open fellowship houses. And even today, I imagine that some of you are meeting for church, one-on-one, family to family, having fellowship, breaking bread together and enjoying some company. And that is so good. And if you want to engage with that too, in the town that you're in, and you'd like to see if there's someone else that you could meet with, again, ask one of the pastors. Maybe we can connect you. Because, you know, I wanted to tell you actually some of the info that I had for you. We have got over 40 other churches relating with us just through Surge. We're worldwide, we're connecting with 80 pastors, including our own pastors. And I have a list of 32 countries here, Canada, Haiti, Australia, South Korea, Philippines, jumping down Rwanda, Nigeria, jumping down again, Liberia, Tanzania, Sierra Leone, DR Congo, England, Scotland, Wales, Norway, Taiwan. So many countries are connecting. And you know, who knows if there aren't believers in your town that we could connect you with. That's happened as locally as Wales. It could be happening in other countries altogether. You know, we're going to read a story in a second or two because I want to revitalize and remind and energize your walk with God again. Because we've said just recently, we want in the 5 o'clock meetings anyway, when we've been breaking bread, we said we wanted to build community around good content. We want to build community, but it needs to be around good content because if all you do when you get together is start to worry or share all the bad news, that doesn't build for a really great time. It can actually leave people more fearful. And this message is about faith, not fear. And so I want to talk to you for a few seconds from a story. Let's read it. It's in Exodus 12 and starting in verse 1. While Moses and Aaron were still in Egypt, the Lord spoke to them. And he said, this month will be the first month of the year for you. In another translation, it says it's the beginning. It means something new is just about to germinate. Something new is just about to spring up. In verse 3, we go on, this command is for the whole community of Israel. On the 10th day of this month, each man must get one lamb for the people in his house. If there are not enough people in his house to eat a whole lamb, then he should invite some of his neighbors to share the meal. I love that, you know, because that's exactly what we're devising through our growth groups and our meetings and our fellowship houses. The opportunity to come together where you can check to see if you're all well. You can check to see that you're growing in faith as well as in other things, and that you've got time together to talk and chat and pray and actually eat and break bread. It's a really healthy thing to do. We read in verse 5, the lamb must be 1 year old, must be a male, and it must be completely healthy. This animal can be either a young sheep or a young goat. You should watch over the animal until the 14th day of the month. And on that day, all the people of the community of Israel must kill these animals just before dark. You must collect the blood from these animals and put it on the top and the sides of the doorframe of every house where the people eat this meal. You can see the type of Christ in that. His blood was shed to give us new life, to bring us protection, to set us free from sickness and fears and doubts. And in this story, we find that they put the blood on the lintel and the doorposts of their places so that there was a sign, a visible sign to say, we're covered. They didn't put it, they were not encouraged to put it down on the threshold, which could have meant that basically they would have been walking over God's provision and kindness. This is pure act of mercy. And even in the Old Testament story that we're reading now, we see the protection and the kindness and the provision of God. It's just an amazing story. In verse 8, it says, on this night, you must roast the lamb and eat all the meat. You must also eat bitter herbs and bread made without yeast. You must not eat you must eat all the meat that night. And if any of the meat is left until morning, you must burn it in the fire. You must boil it in the water and roast the lamb and not cook it in any other way. When you eat the meal in verse 11, it says you must be fully dressed and ready to travel. I like that. And I'll explain why in a few minutes. Fully dressed and ready to travel. You must have your sandals on your feet and your walking stick in your hand. You must eat it in a hurry. Can you imagine? Because this is the Lord's Passover. Tonight I will go through Egypt and kill every firstborn man and animal in Egypt. In this way I will judge all the gods of Egypt and show that I am the Lord. But the blood on your houses will be a special sign. When I see the blood, I will pass over your house. I will cause bad things to happen to the people of Egypt, it says, but none of these bad diseases will hurt you. You will always remember tonight. It will be a special festival for you. Your descendants will honor the Lord with this festival forever. You know, I said a few minutes ago that we need to let the word of Christ dwell in us richly. And in fact, it means to we need to give it the run of the house. We need to let the word come in regularly to take over, to take authority, to govern. Give it the run of the house. Those are strong words, folks. But you know what? If you don't, your own worries will have the run of the house. If you don't, someone else's opinion will have the run of the house. We can also understand it by this phrase, give it plenty of room inside your lives. Many of us were living a life, I believe, where Sunday was church and the rest of the week it was work, family, hobbies, and all the other things. Today's world is demanding that we have the word in our hearts every single day, having the run of the house, doing its work. Haven't I said, let the word do its own work? Haven't I said, there's a promise for every problem? And you know, I'm just wanting to encourage you to read in any way you can and draw down and nourish yourself upon the messages and the verses and the words that God gives you. Like I said, when you're reading the word, you're having a chat with God. He's in conversation with you. I'm conscious, folks, as we go through this story, that there are some unusual things in there. And when we see that this is the first month and it's describing the word beginning, it's a new beginning. In the Hebrew there, it's the word rosh, and that is Hebrew 7:2-1:8, for those of you that check out Strong's, H7218. And it means you've now come into a place where you're having the first of something. You're finding that you need to put it first in place, time and rank, that when you break bread together, when you look at this, practice that you can put into place in your life to deal with fear and to find faith. When you remember to do this, you are deciding that you're putting it in place, time and rank above everything else. You're giving it the chiefest place. It's at the forefront of your thinking. It's carrying the highest priority in your day-to-day routines, and it's become the principle and the top thing. I must say to you, you know, through the Bob group and the Box group, these things can be described to you a bit more fully with the pastors online, or if you wanted to email in at prayingforyou@destiny-church.com. You can ask these questions. There's a way through for you to find out what's going on. But we've placed the breaking of bread into a daily routine now, and we're doing it early, and we're doing it with a sense of urgency, because we know we need to tackle fear. We know we need to nourish and nurture faith. You know, Isaiah 53, let me find that, Isaiah 53 verse 5 says, "But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes were healed." I'm aware, folks, that many people think that they're failing if they take a fear to God. You're not failing. Many people worry that when they share their true heart or their concerns or the things that are really getting them down, that they're kind of disqualifying themselves from God's blessing. You are not. You must be real with God. You must pray these things out loud. You must offload them. Give him your concerns, and then break bread and just remember that you've been encouraged to do this often. You know, in the Gospels where Jesus says, "Do this often in remembrance of me." When you look at the word "often" and "remembrance," it actually, when you dig underneath in the Strong's Concordance again, you find the word "nawa," G-N-A-W, and that's a word that we would think of regarding a dog with a bone. We would think, well, that's a very unusual kind of story to put alongside breaking of bread. But what Jesus is saying is, I can help you deal with fear, because every time a thought rises, you can break bread. I've told you to do this often. I've encouraged you to do it as often as you like. When you picture a dog with a bone, he is so not going to let go, is he? He's going to keep at it, keep going, because there's more in there. I find, folks, every time I break bread with people, that there's something new coming from what they've understood, and it's coming out in the conversation and the prayer. And every time Andrew and I break bread, we seem to have a different take on the blessings of God today. Often they're marrying up with the needs that we have or the concerns that we've been sharing about. But you're encouraged. You are never told, don't do this often. You're never told once a week is enough. You're never told, stop it there. The Bible is encouraging us to do this often. And we put it first. That's what we've decided to do with the Bob groups and the Box groups, to break bread and to see God move. Where the verse there in verse 7 of Exodus 12 says, you know, sprinkle the blood, or spread the blood, or strike the doorpost with the blood. It means you're applying something. It actually is describing the fact that you've assigned this emblem to do work on your behalf. It's not just a nonsensical thing. It's very effective. It's very, very powerful. I heard a story recently of a family who was separated because of travel. And I remember when our boys were tiny, I have a photograph at home where I've just got Simeon as a new baby in my arms. All the boys are around and my mom and dad are there. And I recall at different seasons, Andrew would travel sometimes to Africa for 3 weeks. And I would be like juggling. And in the middle of the stories that you find, is God there? You bet. That's actually what my family looked like. We were 11 years down to brand new. The boys, five of them, 11 years down to brand new. And you know what? I'm mindful that as he was traveling, I needed to stay strong. I needed to get into good routines. I needed to have faith growing. And I needed to have a good confession. I needed to have good friends around me. I talked 5 minutes ago about having good friends. But there was a story I heard recently about someone who was traveling, and he had nightmares thinking that the enemy was going to take his children out while he was away. They were being cared for by grandparents. And he felt to pray, break bread, and plead the blood of Jesus and put a bloodline around his home and his property and his land and his family. And I would encourage you to do that. We can use oil to spot the street or to spot the gatepost, to spot the bedposts even, and just claim that territory back for him. It's just like a symbol. But in this story with this family, when they were traveling, they were told a week later that foxes had died around the perimeter of the land. The dream had been about foxes coming with rabies, but in reality, those five foxes couldn't get past the perimeter fence and they'd all died. He'd pled the blood of Jesus in the name of Jesus, and he'd seen a victory. And I want to say to you folks, we are not just subject to the fears, the worries. We're not just subject to someone else's strategy. We can get into the Word of God and make it work for us. You know, the Lord makes all things new. And when we put that blood on our life and we break bread and we walk towards faith on purpose, we realize and find that the Lord makes all things new. We find that this is a remarkable type of Christ in this Old Testament story. And some of you might be thinking, oh no, I'm not going to get superstitious like that. It's not a superstition. It's a personal, reasonable, real thing you can do every day with your family to guard them and cover them. We need to put this thing in a visible place in our lives. You know, I was saying to someone recently sharing about faith, if we don't have faith in our lives, then we've got nothing to stand up with against the enemy. We've nothing to give our friends and our neighbours because our confession is shot. And we've nothing then to invest into our communities and the projects. We need to do everything by faith. So this isn't really an option. It's something that we've to take ownership for and take responsibility for and grow. I was sharing recently with the worship teams through the Surge conference about worship. And one thing I've noticed that we often say in our teams, we need a cross song, we need proclamation. Cross song is our GPS. It tells us where we are. Are we saved today or not? I'm going to pray with you before we finish today so that we can see God move in lives and give you the opportunity to give your life to the Lord. But then we do proclamation because we're proclaiming how strong he is, how faithful he is, the finished work of the cross, the fact that Jesus rose again to give us life, not leave us in a mess. And, you know, I find often in meetings, when we were having meetings, that people would be singing, but they'd be singing prayers. This is how I feel, and I'm so low, and that the enemy's been able to do this, this, and this, and get me down and out. And you know what? That's not praise, that's prayer. And we need to be very, very careful the routines that we build into our lives. I see as well in this verse 11 of Exodus 12 that they had to be ready to move. They were wearing their shoes and their shoes were fastened on. They had a staff in their hand. They were ready to get going. You know, the lamb was not to be looked on and trampled underfoot, but taken to give energy, taken to give strength, taken to give vim and vigor, and a sense of acceleration. And the way the world is moving at the moment, everything's wanting us to just slow down. I'm so sorry to hear of the fear that's rising in so many places. Fear of money and the lack of it. Fear of the job folding. Fear of the children at school and what they're being taught. Fear of the politics and how it's unsettling everybody. Fear of all these sad and very, very wrong issues of racism. Fear that's trying to divide. There are so many schisms in society. But you know what? We need to realize that this work of the cross takes us from the yoke through the cross to the crown. And we do not have to be underneath all of these things in fear. We can stand with strength. When we find there in verse 11 that they were to gird their loins, it means the small of their back, the slender part of their body, needed to be covered in armor and held in on every side. There might be an area of your life that you think it's really thin around there. I'm hanging on by the skin of my teeth. Gird your loins, get the faith in. The shoes on your feet, they actually give you a symbol of occupancy. Of an enclosed and bolted up space that you've taken ownership of. When you break bread, realize that you're actually putting your shoes on. You're taking authority in your situation and you can stand your ground. You can hold on to the things that you believe in God for. It means that you'll be able to endure your journey. You'll have good solid footwear on and you can go forward in the steps that you need to take today. When the word tells us that they were to have their staff in their hand when they broke bread, again in verse 11, that word is makale, and it's H4731, and it means, would you believe, it means you're just about to be able to germinate. Something of a new shoot is going to spring up. It means you're going to be able to walk and strike and be guided on your journey. With the staff in your hand, It's going to mean you're going to be able to walk and strike and be guided with meaning, with direction, with power and means. You know, none of us needs to do this thing alone. And I'm going to pray with you if you want to give your life to Jesus today. Maybe you're not sure about your salvation. Something happened to you tonight. Do you know for sure you'll be with the Lord? Do you know for sure that you're forgiven of your sins? That huge chasm, that impassable gulf has been bridged? Jesus Christ went on the cross to bridge that gap for you and I. The Passover gives us exemption. It means that we have an exception to ordinary operations. We've been given immunity. We've been given an excuse. We're excused from the performance of legal duty. This is what this word exemption means. It means that things and punishment have been wavered and we are now released. God is so good, you know. He doesn't offer a carrot. He offers eternal life. He doesn't offer a religious life. He offers a relationship. And I really want to pray with you right now, if I may, that God would just step into your world. Please, there are pastors online today ready to pray with you. You can click the live prayer button as soon as we've prayed this prayer together, if you're on church online. If you're in the Facebook chat or on YouTube, you can join that chat and find the prayer connection there to respond. But come on, use my word. I want to help you to become absolutely assured that A, you're born again, and B, you can break bread with faith. God wants you to step up into a new place. I love it. When my eyes are on my master, they are not on those around me. That's what W. Philip Keller says in his book, A Shepherd Looks at Psalm 23. When my eyes are on my master, they are not on those around me. We're going to deal with men fear today, the fear of man. Don't worry what your family think. Don't worry what your colleagues think. You know, I often say we are one with an audience of one. This COVID thing, this world is right now showing people that they actually stand as an individual, and yet they need to be right with God. Pray these words with me, if you would, if you want to give your life to Jesus right now. Say these words, Father God, I thank you for Jesus. He came to show us life. He died upon a cross for my forgiveness of sin. He rose again on the third day to give me new life. I am a sinner and I ask you for forgiveness. I accept Jesus today as my Lord and as my Savior. Thank you that you hear me. I am born again today. Amen. Wow, if you just prayed that prayer, this is so exciting, because you've just begun a new journey. You've begun a new journey to find that you can walk by faith. We find that in 2 Corinthians 5 and verse 17. You can live by faith. You find that in Galatians 2:20 and Hebrews 10:38. You can be saved by faith, which is just what's happened to you. We see that in Ephesians 2 verse 8. You can have faith as your shield. Ephesians 6:16 tells us that. You can be healed by faith. James 5 verse 15 is where we find that scripture. You need to realize that faith comes by hearing, so you need to find a Bible that works for you. You need to also be encouraged that you're sanctified. You can grow on in faith. We find that in Acts 26 verse 18. We have pastors, we mentioned earlier about college, the college courses can teach you lots of things. We've pastors here to pray. We've loads of different meetings, the growth groups where you can talk. But right now, if you'll click on that button and acknowledge with the pastor and let them pray with you again, we want to send you this booklet. It's the beginnings of your walk with God. It's called This Is For You, and it's going to help you start your journey. Maybe you're a new believer and you actually would still love to receive this. Just let us know. Click on the links, write in, do the different things of connecting through Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all the different things. We've so many pastors ready to reach you. We love you. Thank you for hearing me share today. I just want to bless you and say thank you. Stay faithful, stay strong in God, and keep breaking bread. God bless you.
where Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet, my Savior on that cursed tree. His body bound and drenched in tears, they laid him down in Joseph's tomb. The entrance sealed by heavy stone. Messiah still and all alone. Oh, praise the name of the Lord our God. Oh, praise his name for.
I believe you were blessed by that word. And if you responded to the call to come to know Jesus, why don't you press that live prayer button? It is so, so important. Pastors are waiting to connect with you, to help you on that journey. We should never walk it alone. Also, remember, tomorrow at 11 a.m., we'll be right back here for church, so please connect with us.
Has given us a new opportunity to reach our communities. We've expanded our food bank, we've started a hot meal initiative serving the most vulnerable in our city, as well as the NHS and key workers. We have an online counselling service and a hope line, so there's always somebody to talk to. Since the beginning of lockdown, we've given out over 10,000 hot meals and 10,000 food bags. And we thank God because it's only just the beginning. We're preparing to expand what we're doing to continue to meet the needs of our community.
Stop looking for our purpose in everything else and find our purpose in loving the Lord our God.
I'm not focused on the division and the racial strife, though it's real and genuine. We have to take a stand for justice. I'm focused on the joy of heaven.
Be courageous enough, compassionate enough, and righteous enough to stand out, speak out, and act out in this nation, because this nation needs Jesus.
Speak to the mountain. And you know what? That mountain, that demonic force, that principality and power, it's going to have to shift in the name of Jesus.
Very act of singing is causing you to actually put two and two together and see where the enemy's been lying to you and where the Lord has been telling the truth to you.
Lockdown has given us a new opportunity to reach our communities. We've expanded our food bank, we've started a hot meal initiative serving the most vulnerable in our city, as well as the NHS and key workers. We have an online counselling service and a hope line, so there's always somebody to talk to. Since the beginning of lockdown, we've given out over 10,000 hot meals and 10,000 food bags. And we thank God because it's only just the beginning. We're preparing to expand what we're doing to continue to meet the needs of our community.
Stop looking for our purpose in everything else and find our purpose in loving the Lord our God.
I'm not focused on the division and the racial strife, though it's real and genuine. We have to take a stand for justice. I'm focused on the joy of heaven.
Be courageous enough, compassionate enough, and righteous enough to stand out, speak out, and act out in this nation, because this nation needs Jesus.
Speak to the mountain. And do you know what? That mountain, that demonic force, that principality and power, it's going to have to shift in the name of Jesus.
Very act of singing is causing you to actually put two and two together and see where the enemy's been lying to you and where the Lord has been telling the truth to you.
lockdown has given us a new opportunity to reach our communities. We've expanded our food bank. We've started a hot meal initiative serving the most vulnerable in our city, as well as the NHS and key workers. We have an online counselling service and a hope line, so there's always somebody to talk to. Since the beginning of lockdown, we've given out over 10,000 hot meals and 10,000 food bags. And we thank God because it's only just the beginning. We're preparing to expand what we're doing to continue to meet the needs of our community.